3, 2, 1. Command has been given. Crank them up.
Let's go. When I say I don't know, I don't know.
Let's go, baby.
Now, the morning drive.
Buckle up, everybody.
A little bit of this and a little bit of that.
It's a game changer.
I listen to you guys every single day on my way to work.
Well, again, I'm not a doctor, nor do I play one on the radio.
You guys are amazing.
What are you doing over there?
I'm going to the top.
The morning drive with Mike Bagley and Pete Pistone.
To the bat balls.
I want to know who's in your head, stealing your heart while I'm still bleeding. Who's in your bed, wrapped in your arms while I am.
NASCAR Radio, Channel 90, live and on the air. We're in your ears. Mike Bagley here in Del Marvelo Studio 1D. We've got Pistol Pete Pistone in the Faison Palace in Chicago. Sammy and Davey are in Studio 134 of the Beltway Bureau in our nation's capital. We welcome each and every one of you to this TMDJ Tuesday. My playlist brings us to green. The Jonas Brothers brings us to the green flag. Top of the morning to you there, Triple P.
Good morning, Bagman. Good morning, everybody. Happy TMDJ Tuesday to one and all. And the Jonas Brothers, what are their names? Nick, Joe, and the other guy.
Kevin. That's what his birth certificate says.
The is other it Kevin? Guy. The other guy.
He's always the forgotten one.
Case in point. I forgot his name.
Put some respect on Kevin's name, please.
Sorry, Kevin. Sorry. Joe's probably the most famous, right? Or is Nick?
I'd say him and Nick are banging quarter panels at this point.
Really? Huh.
I mean, Joe's the lead singer, so he gets a little bit more. But
right. Exactly. There you have it. Now, were they a TV show that became a pop group, or were they just kind of a pop group? You know, like a lot of them get launched off of television shows. What was that one that means, what, Big Time Rush? Remember that? You know, it's kind of the same idea.
They were they were Disney Channel stars, yes.
There you go.
Big Time Rush, Naked Brothers Band, you know.
There you got to go, Baggy. You got to start on the Disney Channel to be anybody these days. See, we blew it.
Well, I'm glad we've got this worked out at 7:02 a.m.
Well, what else you got? Go ahead.
Your playlist.
Go tell us about going grocery shopping. Come on.
Go ahead. All yours. The floor is yours.
There's nothing to report. Nothing to report at all. Nothing happened here yesterday at all. Hmm. And you know what? Ain't nothing wrong with that every now and then.
not at all.
Nothing going on.
Not at all.
Nothing happened.
Well,
the landing gear is coming down, obviously, on the week. So it's like there's not the normal hustle and bustle of the week that normally is not this week. So I'm actually enjoying it.
Okay. So if you're not having the hustle and bustle, will that mean that on Thursday at 10:45, 10:50, there won't be any extracurricular activity for Larry Mack and Danielle to watch while we're in crosstalk before, you know, the weekend gets kicked off? Or will you still be packing to the last moment to provide Larry and Danielle some entertainment?
I would do it. I would just do it. Even if you don't need to do it, just do it.
I don't know why that...
They love it.
...entertains them so much. I was like, and because this past Friday, it happened this past Friday. Yeah. Or Thursday, I'm sorry. I put a cord in my bag... But they make it sound like I'm getting ready to cross the Sahara into this unknown voyage that I'm not coming back from.
Well, I think this Friday I'm going to change my shirt and just like get my golf stuff on while we're closing up the shop.
Just to grab your club, Petey. Just take some practice swings.
Make some practice swings. Yeah, because I'm going right out to the golf course when we get done on Friday, so I'll do that. Why not?
What they are referring to is this past Thursday, I had to quickly leave because I was wheels up at 1:15. So literally, I'm off the air, out the door, in the car, to the airport. So in the news break, while you know we're coming out of that break, I normally go change clothes into the travel clothes,
which makes sense. To the three of us, we understand why you're doing it, and you need to do it. I get it. It just entertains the hell out of Danielle and Larry Mack.
They are just like, I'm like, y'all don't understand. And it's like I have to go.
They're like, wow, he has places to be. We're like, yeah, he does. Literally, that's where he's going.
Literally, he's going to the airport.
But they get so, I mean, Larry just sits back and just folds his arms and just like is in awe of the whole situation. That was a charger cable, Larry, going into the back. Now, there are times where the folders are flying over here. Now, there are some times where it's an all-out thrash in that 45 break. But, hey, at least I can provide him some entertainment.
Well, Larry comes up with the trends of the show. Not in the last time, 10 times that Bagman's traveled, he has wrapped up his power cord. Let's see if he does it here.
He begins packing normally about 10:40 Eastern time. And that gives about 20 minutes to get to the car.
And then when he right. starts packing up, Pete, you go, Larry, there it is. I told you, Pete.
I told you. I predicted that. See, trends never lie. Trends never lie.
Oh, it's the credit one, one to go.
Who are you watching, Mike Choi? I'm watching Bagman wrap up his cords.
I think that this needs to be clipped and played for Larry Mack during Crosstown. He's probably listening right now, though.
Sure.
No, Larry.
Larry's the best.
Larry doesn't listen.
Yeah, he does.
And Larry,
Larry
you look does. Great today, by the way.
Larry does listen. I get time to time. He'll text me something if I'm gummed up on a stat or some sort of technical thing. For sure he listens.
He's probably up earlier than we are.
Yeah.
Well, maybe not Bagman.
No one's up earlier than me.
Like, this guy's up before we went to bed.
Yeah, what time?
11:45 I got up this morning, son. This morning. That was yesterday.
Well, you're going on vacation, though. Like, you should be, your sleeping should be better because you sleep better when you're not at home. So, like, hey, two weeks of real eye closure there, Bagman. Aren't you excited?
Be locked
well,
down.
Well, last night I got into bed around 11, and then I'm 4:15. Up we go. Here we go. And been digging ever since. Going to be a full day today.
5:15 is not bad. 5 hours, 15 minutes. It's not too bad.
That's what I'm around 5 now. I can't 8. Forget about it, please. I've not had 8 hours of sleep in years. Come on. And they say the older you get, the less sleep that the body.
Yeah.
Well, it needs it, but it doesn't allow it to happen. Especially morning radio.
My dad said that all the time. He used to say that all the time. The older I get, the less sleep I get. That's why when I would take him on road trips, he'd be falling, you know, he'd be sound asleep in the passenger seat. Well, if you'd sleep at home, you'd be a little more company on the road.
There's just something to be said, and I wish I could have more time in the morning to do it. Like, I wish I got up earlier to have more time, but like, I just like being up when like the sun is not out yet. Now, you know, that no one else is up, you can just kind of do stuff. There's been a couple times the Harris Teeter by me opens up at like 6 o'clock on a Saturday morning, and I will be at that Harris Teeter at 6:03 and just getting stuff that I need. I'm shopping by myself. There's no one around. It's fantastic.
I've been doing it for years. Listen, the most awesome time of day is about 2 a.m. to 5 a.m.
Okay, no.
I would hardly disagree with that.
I'd go like 5 after, but no. 2 to 5, what are you doing? Nothing happens after 2 a.m.
Listen, I can get up and I can do all this stuff around the house that I do my stat work and all this stuff that I do. That's the best time to do it because there's nobody calling you. There's nobody texting you. There's nobody emailing you or trying to FaceTime you. It's like you don't have, and I like it being dark. I mean, I get a sense of satisfaction that I'm getting a lot of stuff done without interruption and knowing that everybody else is sleeping. I'm getting my stuff done. I love that. To me, that's the best time of day right there. Love it. As far from that perspective of trying to get things done uninterrupted, because as you know, once everybody comes to life and from here on out until, you know, whenever, the cell phones get lit up, text messages flying, and I just like that solace of that time of
flat flying.
Speaking of flat flying, so there's a situation the other day here that we're getting more updates on, but there was this sonic boom that happened in this part of the country the other day when I guess F-16s were scrambled to intercept this Cessna jet that was unresponsive to air traffic control. Well, come to find out that it was flying to New York City from the south, and they had a problem, and it sounds like the same thing happened to them that happened to Payne Stewart, where the cabin became depressurized, and they were trying to get the pilot's attention. The pilot is slumped over the controls, and ultimately, the plane just it was not shot down. It just crashed into the Virginia, you know, countryside there.
The Shenandoah area.
And they had to go supersonic to intercept it, and that's what created the
boom.
Sonic boom. Yeah. Now, there was a 90-minute delay in getting that to happen. They're trying to get to the bottom of it. But for those of us that were around in the Northeast and you heard that boom, scared the bejesus out of a lot of people.
Yeah, sure.
That's you don't get that a lot. Now, when Washington's involved, obviously, with events that have happened prior to this, when a plane pierces that secure airspace, you're asking for it, and that's when things like that take place, but they're showing video and updates and all that, what happened. But can you imagine that you live for that moment? If you're that pilot,
Mm-hmm.
It's like, now this is not a drill. This is the real deal. And you just sit there and wait for moments like that. They got that moment over the weekend. I can't imagine that adrenaline rush of trying to get that plane up in the air and then going supersonic speeds to try to intercept it. Man, that's got to be crazy.
768 miles an hour is supersonic speed.
Yeah. Man, get it.
Get in there, man.
Stand in that gas.
Get in there. That is quite literally unfathomable to me to go that fast.
It's the need for speed, baby.
And I've seen, like, I was standing on the roof at Daytona one year when the Thunderbirds were practicing, and I literally saw, like, the sound barrier break. One of the coolest things I've ever seen. But it's just unfathomable to me to go that fast.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the sound that came out of Chicago this weekend were because of three sold-out Taylor Swift shows that we had there at Soldier Field. So I was down there on Wednesday for that Chicago Street Circuit NBC event, and I saw them setting up barriers and things like that. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, 65,000 people, all three nights. We had perfect weather here, which is good. Sold out crowds, and everything went fine. You know, we were able to handle big events here in Chicago, so we'll be okay for the street circuit race. But there was a story, and I guess this is not just here, it's about around all of her concerts, where people are saying they have concert amnesia.
What is this about? I've seen it. What is going on?
The people apparently get so worked up being in the Taylor Swift concert environment that they can't remember any of the concert when they come out of the concert.
It's like hysteria, essentially.
Let me tell you something. For the tickets that she's charging, I better remember that concert. I got news for you.
Well,
girl,
I don't.
Concert amnesia, Baggy.
I don't understand, like, why are you getting so worked up?
Well,
it's like, it's okay to be excited. Don't get me wrong. I was like, oh my gosh, Taylor Swift is coming. But to get worked up to the point that you're inducing amnesia on yourself.
Mm-hmm. I mean, this isn't like a
new
thing.
I've never been that worked up.
This isn't a new thing, though. Like, look at the old videos, like when the Beatles would come play or when Elvis would come play. Right. Girls would like faint in the crowd and stuff because they were so excited to see them. They were so worked up.
Right.
This is not new.
Taylor Swift.
I think part of it, though, is remember the whole snafu with Ticketmaster and getting the tickets and like, I mean, there's been videos of her performing in absolute downpours because she like not to be like a Taylor Swift stan or anything, but like she understands what her fans went through to try to get those tickets and the money they spent. So she's putting on hell of a show.
I get all of that, but I don't understand what is it about this young lady that gets people whipped up so much.
She's very relatable to
this.
She's
episode.
Very relatable to young women. Like she has a massive fan base.
Well, but I mean, he's right. The Beatles, Elvis, you're right.
They have
Springsteen. I remember people the same deal with him.
But my point, like, I know you just, it's not your type of music. It's not my type of music either. Young women love that. Love it.
They love it.
I mean, they absolutely love it. And she has a huge, like Pete said, she sold out 365,000 seat shows and she's done it every single show on this tour.
And she's adding more dates.
And like
3 hour
people
show
are,
too.
People are standing out who can't get in or standing outside of the venues, like singing along with the songs
They're
and
tailgating.
Stuff like that. It's insane.
It's insane. So I know.
Totally insane. I just don't there is nobody on this planet that could work me up into a lather that much. Nobody.
Okay. Yes, there is, Mike.
If you went to a Patti LaBelle front row.
No, I've been in Patti LaBelle's front row.
Easy.
Concert hall.
Wow. What happened with that, Maggie?
Good morning.
Shout out to Patti LaBelle, baby.
From now on, I'm gonna, instead of saying that, I was on the front row.
I've been on the front row for concerts before. I've seen artists before. I just have never been moved to... just never been moved to, like, faint, pass out, or just... get so whipped up that I can't remember anything about what just happened. I've never been that worked up before.
I get it. It, Sam, to your point, it's not my cup of tea, but I have to give it to her because she does understand her fan base. She does 3 hour shows all three nights. And I have a couple of friends. One of them is a sports writer here in Chicago. He took his daughters. He was sort of the chaperone. I talked to him yesterday and he goes, the joy on their faces was worth me sitting through something that really wasn't his cup of tea. So I get it all. I really do. But not to the, I mean, it does stink. Hey, how was that concert you went to? What concert? I mean, I don't know if it's that bad. Really? What day was it? Saturday? I don't remember
anything.
It's
any like, wow, you must have had a good night. Oh, yeah, I don't remember.
Girl. I mean, it's not like being in Patti LaBelle's front row, but I get it. It's still good.
Oh, I'll tell you what.
She's packing them in. I'll tell you that.
She's packing them in.
Then who is like the baggy? Obviously, you're not going to go hysterical and faint. Dead or alive, one musical artist that you could just, if you could be front row for, dead or alive, who would it be?
Prince.
That's a good one.
That'd be a pretty good one.
Big Prince guy.
That's a good one. Mine obviously is the Beatles. I mean, God, that would have been so cool to see them all perform. I saw McCartney at Wrigley Field, and it was like just seeing him was cool. I can't imagine seeing all the Beatles.
Do you remember it?
I do remember it.
That's good.
I remember where I parked. I remember where I parked.
Show and catch me.
What about Wayne Newton?
He was busy at the hockey game last night.
You see Wayne Newton last night putting the siren at the Vegas Knights? Come on. God bless him. I mean, he has had so much work. You bounce a quarter off his forehead, you get two dimes and a nickel. That's how tight that is. My God.
It's honest to God, like I'm looking at a picture of him. Oh, I'm looking at a picture of him, and I know this is terrible.
He looks like a mannequin.
It is the skin's pulled so far up, like
I know.
I don't know how old he is, but like even when like
81.
He's
81.
So after he was done ringing the siren, like he turned, but it was in like slow motion. Everything was just like a robot.
It's so when he smiles, his knee goes up. I mean, that's how much skin's been pulled up tight.
When he's sleeping, he's smiling. He can't move.
He smiles.
Well,
people
stuck.
I'm going to Vegas Friday, and I was looking around for some shows and whatever. So you got Newton, you got Barry Manilow. Speaking of being pulled tight,
him too. Him
and
too.
Then you've got Carrot Top. I mean, Rita Rudder's not even performing. It's like, what are we doing out here? I mean, we're wasting our time. We're like, what the hell's going on out here? But you've got the Rat Pack salute to this. You got the Sir Michael Jackson show. You've got this, you got that. And it's like, none of this at all. Just
really?
Nothing. Seinfeld. No, I don't know.
Oh, Seinfeld's there?
Nothing. Yeah. He's really? He's at Caesars.
Is he driving around in a car to get coffee? Baggies and cars getting coffee? Mike, what's the deal with this?
Baggies and buggies getting...
What's the deal with Stuart Haas Racing?
That was an L3 penalty!
What's the deal with Newton smiling and his leg going up?
It's Cedric Rackdellen!
It's the summer of Kyle!
It's Austin on Austin!
Yeah, see, I can't sit through 2 hours of that. I just can't. Sorry. 22-minute doses is fine with me.
It's a pretty nice car you got here, Bagman.
So what's the deal
with Cindric and Dylan? I mean, SMT is fine.
Oh, by the way, speaking of that, did you see the we gotta hit a break here.
Yeah, we do.
I was gonna say, did you see the alternate angle of that crash of the 3 and the 2? I saw Dave tweet this out yesterday, and the alternate angle is from turn 1 where the 3 moves up into the 2.
Yes.
And then
Sorry, Austin. I know you're pissed, but you got no case on that one. That was not a purposeful.
That's Austin Dillon, not Austin Cindric.
Well, that's true. Two guys named Austin getting together. What was Austin Terrio busy?
Well, you know what? It was Chase and Chase last week. Austin and Austin this week.
Yes.
Okay. What do we got here? Kyle and Kyle maybe coming up.
Oh.
Who else do we have? That's a double name in this series. There's not two Bubbas, is there? Bubba Pollard, watch out.
No,
I think he's not racing.
Kevin Jonas and Kevin Harvick.
Not racing again.
No, wait, Kevin's the third Jonas brother?
Correct.
Doing it for Dale.
Number 3.
Coming up on the show, bottom of the hour, headline check number 1.
Get out of Patti LaBelle's front row.
We'll get Tuesday takeaways underway with you at 866 Pit Lane. We've got Elton Sawyer, NASCAR Senior VP of Competition, coming up. 8:50, we'll give you the calendar. Coming up at 9, another installment of Behind the Wheel with Joey Logano. Joey will be with us for the entire hour, and we'll talk trucks at 10:30 Eastern with Stuart Friesen. Again, 866 Pit Lane, that puts you in touch with us. And you can tweet us as well at SiriusXM NASCAR, #TMD NASCAR.